Finally, Mama Trista, we have the 2024 Isuzu D-Max, and today let's talk about all the details for the 2024 model year. Itong D-Max na to is a mid-cycle refresh or kumbaga minor update lang siya. Pero it is quite significant update compared to the recent updated D-Max that we had na parang wheels lang yung nabago, the fascia didn't even change. For this new model, Isuzu updated the technology dito sa ating D-Max, especially sa ating front lighting and also the interior. So if you want to know all of those, watch this video. The new D-Max looks like a bumblebee na mamotorista, no, sa Transformers na movie. I really like the new design, especially sa kanyang grill. It's a lot more wider, more aggressive, and also sophisticated din. So it's way up there when it comes to the styling. So now, itong 2024 model year, they've taken a step further with its design. Meron na tayong new headlights, and this headlight has bi-beam LEDs. Finally, we also get LED turn signal lights, and also redesigned din yung ating DRLs with a more sophisticated look na nasa taasan na yung ating form niya. Yung ating LED DRLs, which is really, really nice looking. Now, at the grill naman, they have made a lot of changes, no? So it's a more open type design, and you can see the grill, Mama Trista, hindi siya ganun ka maliliit yung ating mga butas, malalaki talaga to make sure that you have good airflow papunta sa ating engine. So housing our fog light din sa harap natin, meron din tayong bagong design sa ating lower part ng bumper. It is of that more parang gaping hole na design, Mama Trista, no? It really looks nice. Very competitive na yung kanyang design with the likes of Toyota Hilux Conquest and Ford Ranger Wildtrak. Now, dito din sa ating D-Max, Mama Trista, no, it's basically the same yung form ng ating body, nothing change there. Now, moving on to the back, you can see na meron din tayong bagong taillights. It's a more tri-type LED design. Meron tayong LED sa taasan, sa mid part, and sa lower part ng ating taillights. Now, aside sa ating taillights, we also have a new design sa ating rims naman. So basically, they are still 18-inch rims, pero mas iba na yung design. I think the current one that we have sa ating D-Max already looks good, and I think if they retain that rim, it still would be really nice looking, no, for this 2024 model year. Isuzu also made quite a lot of changes in terms of infotainment system and integration. Noon kasi yung ating D-Max has a more of that aftermarket na infotainment system. So wala siyang volume knob, so you have to use the touchscreen, which is kind of distracting when you're driving. I really like na 10.1-inch display siya, or 10.2-inch display. Yung definition niya is quite lacking, but I really appreciate na meron na yung CarPlay and Android Auto. Now, for that time, it was quite advanced, but now in 2024, it's kind of dated na. So now, for the 2024, hopefully we'll get this in the Philippines. Meron na tayong mga volume knobs and tuning knobs dun sa ating head unit. Integrated yung ating infotainment system sa buong sasakyan. So, ano nga ba yung ibig sabihin ng integration na yan? So, you can change some settings on the car using the infotainment system, such as yung ADAS natin. So, yung ADAS natin also has some changes, no? So, they made the lens wider, so to cover more area on the sides of the vehicle para mas accurate yung tracing ng ating adaptive cruise control, and also yung ating lane keeping assist, or yung ating lane departure alert. Aside from that, meron tayong rear differential lock for the automatic models in Thailand. Hopefully, Isuzu Philippines will bring it dito sa Pilipinas, yung diff lock for the automatic variant, not just the manual variant. The new D-Max also now has rough terrain mode, so you have drive modes for off-roading, so that will alter the traction control system, the way that the transmission works, para mas ano siya, mas pabor, no, for off-road use. Another big change for the D-Max for the 2024 model year is the screen up front. We now have, I think, a 7-inch display dito sa harap natin, or an 8-inch display. I'm not so sure about that. Lalagay ko na lang sa video na to. But it is really hard to see the details dun sa ating driver display. Kasi maliit lang siya, Mama Trista, and you have lots of things that's going on that screen. So pati yung gear indicator andun siya. Now they ditched that small screen and gone with a full digital display up front. So mas malaki na yung makikita mo na mga features, and also yung trip meters natin, kitang-kita mo na yan. You have a redesign din sa ating gauge cluster. So analog yung ating rev counter pero yung speedometer is on the screen na. And also meron pa din tayong temperature gauge and fuel gauge, which is what we want, no? Permanent talaga yan. Now let's move on to another change is that si D-Max meron na siyang paddle shifters. So you can now take control of the D-Max, no, using the paddle shifters for the 6-speed automatic transmission. Before you just use the ano the shifter, no, pero ngayon it's a lot more easier, much more controllable because of that paddle shifters. But you don't really need it, but I think it's a welcome change naman din. Minor interior differences like the leather seats is basically same din sila dun sa previous model. Engine stays the same. A 1.9 liter or 3.0 liter turbo diesel engine from Isuzu. We all know it is very reliable, very serviceable engine. It has a decent amount of power at 190 PS and 450 Newton meters of torque. Hopefully, dalhin lahat ni Isuzu Philippines na yung nakikita natin sa Thailand kasi it would be a mess, no, for them to charge a lot of money for the new D-Max and then not deliver on the features that we want, no, sa isang pickup truck. Especially now na napaka-tight yung competition with the Ford Ranger, Toyota Hilux, especially with their latest offerings, no, like the Toyota Hilux GRS, diba? So, again, it's a competitive market, no, for the pickup truck segment dito sa Philippines. And definitely, if Isuzu wants to have more sales sa kanilang D-Max, they need to step up their game, especially sa spec and features na dalhin nila dito sa Pilipinas. I think they should offer more and charge less for that. Hopefully, we will get that, mga motorista, dito sa ating 2024 D-Max. So ayun mga motorista, what do you think sa ating video today? Short video lang. And I hope you like this video and do follow and like Motorista Adventures on our YouTube and Facebook page. Maraming salamat and I'll see you on the next episode.